Hi, I'm Libby Lewis, a speech-language pathologist at Island Hospital. Do you find yourself searching for words that used to come to you without any difficulty? I'm here to talk about that on the tip of my tongue experience. Here are a few suggestions for ways to work around the common challenge of word recall. First, pause. Take a breath. Sometimes all you need is just a little extra time for that word to come to you. Second, try to identify the first letter or sound of the word by picturing the word in your mind or letting your mouth form the first sound. The rest of the word usually will follow. Third, talk around the word. Describe it. If it's an object or an activity, what does it look like? Who uses it? Who does it? Where do we find it or see it being done? While talking about the word, often something you say will trigger the actual word you're looking for. Fourth, use gestures. Pantomiming how something is used or what size it is or what shape it is, especially if you're describing it, often gives you or your conversation partner the information that they need to guess the word for you. Perhaps you're not the one who's struggling with these challenges, but you know someone who is. Sometimes it's helpful to supply the word for people when they're searching for them, just to keep the conversation going. Other times, though, it may be important for that person to come up with the word themselves. So in those moments, you can reduce the pressure that they feel by just patiently giving them a little extra time. Or if you know the word that they're trying to say, give them the first sound of the word or a leading phrase that's commonly associated with it. For example, if someone was talking to me and searching for the word coffee, they might say, "Oh, I'd sure like some," and I might say some ca, or I might say a cup of ca, and they say, "Oh, coffee, yes, I want some coffee." People with word-finding difficulties can get frustrated sometimes, either because their conversation partners often speak for them too frequently, supplying every word they hesitate on. But they also can get frustrated if the person knows what the word is that they're searching for and don't provide it for them, leaving them to struggle. This can leave the conversation partner feeling like they just can't win. So I recommend that you establish hand signals with your most frequent conversation partners to identify when help is wanted and when it isn't. A hand up or a finger up like this may mean, oh, wait, I want to figure this out myself. While this gesture means, yeah, go ahead, help me if you know the word. If you would like to enhance these skills in your own life, talk to your doctor and he or she can refer you to a speech pathologist to work with you directly. Or you can call the Island Hospital Physical, Occupational, and Speech Therapy Department at 360-299-1328 for further information.